Assalamu alaikum everyone. Today we are going to start unit number 2, lesson number 4, sentences conjunction. Conjunction means joining of sentences, joining of words. So in this, match the two parts to make complete sentence. Here we read the statement and match one part to the other to complete the full statement. So there is an example. Tiny horse collected some straws and built a straw house. So tiny horse woke up because the house was shaking but could not blow it down. But tiny horse escaped, so they built one of the bricks. So what is a suitable statement for this sentence? Tiny horse woke up because the house was shaking. This one, the first one. Because the house was shaking. Number two, the wolf blew down the straw house but tiny horse escaped. So they built one of the brick but could not blow it down. So the suitable statement for this sentence is, but tiny horse escaped. The wolf blew down the straw house but tiny horse escaped. The horse needed a strange house but could not blow it down. So they built one of the bricks. So the right statement is, so they built one of the bricks. The horse needed a stronger house, so they built one of the bricks. The wolf blew at the brick house but could not blow it down. After joining the sentences, come to the question number 2. Join the pair of sentences with so or because. As you know that so is used to express the extreme action, so is used to refer to and agree of something, and because is used to when we express and when we show the reason and cause of something, we use because. Example, the goats were afraid. The wolf was in the mountains. The right statement is, the goats were afraid because the wolf was in the mountains. Number 2, the goats needed a strong house. They built a brick house. And the right statement is, the goats needed a strong house, so they built a brick house. Now come to the sentences. Shorthorns went to the store because he wanted to buy some bricks. Here this show the reason of something, so we will write because here. As you know that here is a full stop. When we remove the full stop and write the because, the first capital letter of he converted into the small capital letter of alphabet of he, like this. Number 2, he did not buy any bricks there because they were too expensive. Here to show the reason, here to show the cause, so that's why you will write because here. At the brick factory, they were much cheaper, so they bought 500 bricks. So you will write the word so here because it shows the extreme action, it shows the agreement. He borrowed a cart because there were so many bricks. So you would write a word because, got to show the reason. But he could not pull the cart because it was too heavy. He ran to get longhorns and tiny horse, so he needed help. They were afraid of the wolf. They built their house very quickly. They did not like smoky house, so they put a chimney in the roof. Hope you people will understand the concept of so and because. Now come to the question number 3. Punctuate this passage and choose the correct conjunction to complete the sentences. And, but, so, because. So, now discuss the each word in detail. And, we use and to connect two word phrases and clause together. But is used to connect the ideas, but is used to connect two different things that are not in agreement. And so is used to express the extreme action, so is used to connect an independent clause with an independent clause. Because the word because is used when we express the reason or cause of something, we use because. Now let's read the paragraph. A sleepless night. I was not sleeping well. I was dreaming about the wolf. Here this show the reason of the dreaming, so that's why you will write the word because here. Because I was dreaming about the wolf in the story, suddenly I woke up and heard a noise. And here you will write the word and, because it connects the first sentence with the other sentence. But a noise outside the house, it sounded like the big wolf. At first I was afraid and I did not get out of the bed. I tried to get to sleep again, but I could not. As we know, but it's used to connect the ideas, but I could not. Then I heard the noise again, so I got out of the bed and went to the window. I looked out of the window, but I could not see anything. Then I saw an animal under the tree. It was not a wolf, but its tail was longer than a wolf's tail. Suddenly it ran up the tree and I saw it was a monkey. I went back to bed and went to sleep. Now come to page number 11, unit number 2, lesson number 5, the three little goats, part 2. Here we will discuss about the part 2 of three little goats. In this, the goats heard wolf tried to climb inside the house through the chimney. So they planned to pull wolf's tail into the pot of hot water and pull him into the pot of hot water. They put the, and after pulling him into the pot of hot water, they put the lid on the top of the pot and put a heavy stone on the lid. So in this way they end the big wolf. Now let's read the paragraph. The three little goats heard the wolf climb inside the top of the chimney. They were afraid. Oh no, the wolf is coming down the chimney. They shouted together. Quick, said Tiny Horse, put more sticks on the fire. It will be too hot for Wolfie. But the wolf continued to climb down the chimney. Quick, said Short Horns, put some wet leaves on the fire. It will be too smoky for the Wolfie. But the wolf continued to climb down the chimney. Quick, said Longhorns, put more sticks on the fire. Move the pan of the hot water over the flames. The water will be too hot for the wolfie. Soon they could see the wolf's tail above the fireplace. Quick, said Tiny Horns, pull. So they pulled the wolf's tail and the wolf fell into the pot of boiling water. Here you can see the boiling water and the tail of the wolfie. They pulled the wolfie tail into the boiling water. Short Horns hit the wolf on the head with a big iron spoon. Long Horns put the lid on the pot. The Tiny Horns put a heavy stone on the lid. So that was the end of the big wolf. Now highlight the dictation words. Heard, afraid, chimney, continued, smoky, wolfy, sticks, flames, quick, pull, fireplace, lid, iron spoon. Now, question number 2. Are these sentences true or false? If these sentences are true, then you will write the alphabet T. If these sentences are false, then you will write the alphabet F in front of the statements. Example, the wolf was too big to climb down the chimney. So this is false, so write the word alphabet F here. The goats made the fire and the water hotter. This is true, so write T here. The wet leaves on the fire made the chimney very smoky. This is true, so write the alphabet T here. The goats saw the wolf's head appear in the fireplace. This is false, so write the word alphabet F here. As you know that they saw the tail of the wolfie. The wolf escaped from the pot. This is true or false, and this is false because they killed the wolfie. Now come towards question number 3. Use your own words to complete these sentences. Here you will use your own words to complete the sentences. Number 1. The third house did not fall down because it was made of bricks. As you know that the third house was strongly made of wood, so you will write that it was made of bricks. Number 2. The wolf could not dare, so he climbed down the chimney. The wolf could not blow the house down. The wolf could not blow the house down, so he climbed down the chimney. Number 3. The goats tried to make the fire hotter, so they dashed. So they put sticks on the fire. The goats tried to make the chimney smoky, so they dashed. So they put some wet leaves. So they put some wet leaves. Number 5. The goats pulled the wolf down by its tail and dashed the pole and dropped him into the pot. Number 6. The goats dashed so the wolf could not escape. The goats planned to put Wolfie into the pot of boiling water so the Wolfie could not escape. Grade 3. Now open your book at page number 17. Lesson 5. Pronouns. The words that are used at place of nouns are called pronouns. For example, the words they, he, she, their, her and it are called pronouns because they have been used in place of the proper nouns. This makes the reading much more interesting. Read the following paragraph. Kathy and Stan were excited because Kathy and Stan were going to France for a holiday with Kathy and Stan's parents. As soon as Kathy and Stan came home, Kathy and Stan ran to the rooms to pack Kathy and Stan's suitcases. Now read this version and see which one is better and why. Kathy and Stan were excited because they were going to France for a holiday with their parents. As soon as they came home, they ran to their rooms to pack their suitcases. Let us understand. Write the following sentences in your notebook. Replace the proper nouns with a suitable pronoun where required. This is Angela's book. Please give it to Angela. Her. This is Anita's ruler. Please return the ruler to Anita. Her. Mr. Saul is my neighbor. Mr. Saul has bought a new music system. Here we will use he. Mr. Saul plays the music so loud that everyone gets disturbed. He plays the music so loud that everyone gets disturbed. Patsy and Roland have a pet dog called Buddy. They are very fond of it. Patsy and Roland, we will use here they, take Buddy out for a walk every evening. Take it out for a walk every evening. Now on page number 18, copy the sentences in your notebook, complete them with the correct pronoun in the blanks. You may refer to the table given in the box. For singular, we use I, and plural we and us, you. He, she, it, we use they, her or him, them, mine, ours, yours, yours, his, hers, theirs. The car in the garage is ours. My father bought Dash yesterday, it yesterday. This is Stella's book. Dash will give it to her. I'll give it to her. Mr. Brown and his family are waiting at the airport. Dash are going to Switzerland for a holiday. They are. This is not our suitcase. Dash is your Dash. It is yours. Read the following pairs of sentences. One sentence in each pair is correct. Find the correct one and write it in your notebook. Ron is sure he will come to his party. Ron is sure him will come to his party. This sentence is correct. I think them is Alice swimsuit. I think it is Alice swimsuit. This one sentence is correct. My hobby is playing the piano and drums. What is yours? My hobby is playing the piano and drums. What is you? This is the correct sentence. Mrs. Gray gave these books to I. Mrs. Gray gave these books to me. Complete these sentences by choosing the correct option. Write them in your notebook. The boys played very well. The headmaster said the school is proud of him or them. Here are the word boys. Boys are the plural, so we will put here them. Lisa wants to use the phone. Shall I allow her or she? Her. Which country do you or your belong to? Do you? Ron is riding the bicycle which Uncle John gave him on his birthday. He loves riding it. It belongs to him only. Now on page number 19, extended exercise. Read the discussion that is children are having. Correct the sentences which are wrong in your notebook. Peter, the school will be celebrating Children's Day next week. Teacher says us must do something exciting. Teacher says we must do something exciting
Let us think what we can do. Sam, we can put up a play or a dance program. Roger, Penny writes nice poems. Why not ask her to recite one of her poems? Jan, Alice and I have written a script for a play. It has 7 characters. Who is good at acting?